Welcome to 21st session of Management Accounting, 5th semester BBA, Bengaluru North University. In this session, we are going to prepare the trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet with the help of accounting ratio. In the problem, some ratios will be given and some information will be given. With the help of that accounting ratios and other information, we need to prepare the trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. So, in the previous session also, we have solved one problem on preparation of trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet with the help of accounting ratios. The main objective of this chapter is to familiarize the students with the ratio analysis as a tool for financial analysis. Next, the main session outcome is that the students will be able to critically think and prepare financial statement using accounting ratios. This is the problem. Here, using the following data, complete the balance sheet below. Here some information are given. With the help of that, we have to complete this balance sheet. What are the information that is given here? The first one is gross profit, 20% on sales rupees, 1,20,000 is given. With the help of this transaction, we can able to calculate the sales, that is gross profit is given. This gross profit is equal to 20%. So we can calculate the sales. Shareholders equity, the amount is given. Credit sales to total sales, 80% is given. With the help of first adjustment, we can able to calculate the sales, and in that sales, 80% is the credit sales. Next, total asset turnover ratio is given 3 times. The formula is also given here, sales divided by total asset. With the help of first adjustment, we can able to calculate the sales, and with the help of this total turnover, total asset turnover ratio, we can able to calculate the total asset. So this total asset is also the total liabilities. Next, inventory turnover ratio is also given, that is 8 times. Here, for the purpose of calculating this inventory turnover ratio, we have to take the cost of sales, that is cost of goods sold. The formula for calculating the cost of goods sold is sales minus gross profit. Then, average collection period, here 360 days in a year is given, and average collection period is the 18 days. Here, usually we will take 365 days, but in the problem they have given, we need to take 360 days only. Next, current ratio is given, 1.6:1. With the help of this, we can able to calculate the current assets and current liabilities. Then long term debt to equity, 40% is there. Here already they have given shareholder equity, that is 1 lakh. So long term debt is 40% of this shareholder's equity. Now with the help of all this information, we need to calculate or prepare the balance sheet. Now first one is calculation of cost of goods sold. As I told here, first adjustment that is given, gross profit 20% on sales rupees 1,20,000. So for 20% gross profit, and the amount is 1,20,000. And for 100%, how much? That 100% is called as sales. Now cross multiplication, 1,20,000 into 100 divided by 20. The sales amount will be 6 lakh. Then cost of goods sold. The formula is sales minus gross profit. So 6 lakh minus 1,20,000, cost of goods sold is 4,80,000. Then calculation of inventory or average stock. for a stock turnover ratio, that is given inventory turnover ratio 8 times. Okay, with the help of that we can able to calculate the average stock or inventory. Now stock turnover ratio, the formula is cost of goods sold divided by average stock. Stock turnover ratio is 8, cost of goods sold we have calculated 480,000 divided by average stock. If you are simplifying this, we will get average stock is rupees 60,000. Next, calculation of long term debt. As I told, long term debt adjustment is given here, that is long term debt to equity is 40%. Here equity is given, that is 1 lakh. 1 lakh into 40% is the long term debt. Then calculation of debtor turnover ratio. So how to calculate this debtor turnover ratio? Here average collection period, that is called as debt collection period, is given 18 days. And in the problem they have given that 360 in a year. So here we have to change the formula, that is debt collection period is equal to 360 days divided by debtor turnover ratio. That is debt collection period is 18, 360 divided by debtor turnover ratio. So debtor turnover ratio is 20 times. Next, calculation of debtor or average debtor. Here how to calculate the debtor or average debtor? We have calculated the debtor turnover ratio. With the help of the debtor turnover ratio, we can calculate the debt. What is the formula for debtor turnover ratio? Credit sales divided by average debtors. Here credit sales is given 80% to cash sales. Okay, sales we have calculated 6 lakhs into 80%. Credit sales is 480,000. With the help of this debtor turnover ratio and credit sales, we can able to calculate the average debtor. That is debtor turnover ratio 20, credit sales 480,000 divided by average debtor. So average debtor will be rupees 24,000. Then we can able to calculate the total asset with the help of total asset turnover ratio. That is sales divided by total assets. Total asset turnover ratio, it is given in the problem, that is 3 times. And sales already we have calculated 6 lakhs divided by total assets. So total assets will be rupees 2 lakh. Next, we need to prepare the balance sheet. Already all the items, now what should be there in the balance sheet, that has given in the problem. First one is the shareholder equity. This is given in the problem, that is 1 lakh as it is we have to write. Then long term debt we have calculated 40,000. Then fixed asset we have not calculated. Sundry debtors we have calculated, that is 24,000. Then inventory we have calculated 60,000. And this sundry creditors also we have not calculated. Okay. First, we should write shareholder equity, long term debt, then sundry debtors and inventory. After this, we have to write the total asset. This total assets we have calculated. So, asset is 2 lakh rupees and liabilities will be 2 lakh only. Okay, now here liability side we can calculate the sundry creditors, because shareholders equity they have given in the problem, long term debt we have calculated, and 2 lakh minus 1 lakh 40,000, the remaining balance is the 60,000, that is the balancing figure, that is called as sundry creditors. Okay, then after calculating the sundry creditors, here asset side we have not yet calculated the fixed assets and the cash. I will tell you now how to calculate this fixed asset and cash. So here we have calculated the sundry creditors. Now move on to the next one. Calculation of current asset. Current ratio is given in the problem, that is 1.6:1. Okay. Now, there are sundry creditors we know, and liability side only three items are there, that is the shareholders' equity, long-term debt and sundry creditors. Okay. Only one current liability is there. That current liability is sundry creditors of rupees 60,000. Here current ratio is given 1.6:1. Means here current assets is 1.6 and current liabilities is 1. Okay. For 1, that is current liability 60,000, means for 1.6 how much, that is current asset. Current assets is equal to 1.6 × 60,000/1. So current asset is rupees 96,000. With the help of this 96,000, that is the current asset, we are going to calculate the cash. Already in this current asset, there are two current assets are there. The balance sheet we have calculated sundry debtors and the inventory. See, cash is equal to current assets, that is 96,000. Sundry debtors and inventory we have calculated, that is 24,000 and 60,000. The balancing figure is the 12,000, that is the cash. Okay, that cash we have to write. Now 2 lakh minus 24,000 minus 60,000 minus 12,000. The balancing figure is 1,04,000, that is the fixed asset. Okay, you have to keep on trying and you can able to solve the problem easily. Thank you.